let's see what we have in here. I already threw the Heineken can away. I was like, oh, so we just going to leave the Heineken can in here. It's amazing that the case managers, because they went to look at this place before they said, okay, we're gonna take it. They have these cabinets open. I don't know why they didn't see that Heineken can. Now, what if I was an ex-alcoholic and then I had a relapse because they didn't pick up that Heineken can?
So I'm in the parking lot now, and this is what they consider accessible. If I had a wheelchair, this would be difficult. You see this? One. Where am I? One. Two. Oh, three. At least it's a beautiful day out here. Okay, I hope nobody comes out while I'm filming this. So I'm outside. I'm supposed to see if there's anything wrong with the outside. So far, so good. I do like the fact that they have a valet for the trash. Trash was in the valet bin before I moved in. Okay. Let's see if this doorbell works. The doorbell doesn't work. Okay. Let's see if anything wrong with the door. Just a bad paint job. I guess they had to rush to find me something. A lot of paint splatter on the floor. I don't know how long ago it was that they painted, but throughout the whole apartment complex is this dark gray paint everywhere. The crown molding looks okay. I mean, you know, I don't know how long this apartment's been here. Okay. Going into the entryway, but I gotta put it on pause because I gotta get my walker up. Let's talk about these steps. Let's get my cane again. So it's got a little lip. You got, this is the lower. Then a lip, and then another lip. So of course with me, I have to, sorry about that. I have to turn around backwards to get into the apartment. Okay, well I got the walker in there. I'm trying to film the entryway and the walker's in the way, but we're gonna do what we do. So let's see if this light switch works. Well, the light switch is on, as you can see, and the light here in the entryway is not on. The other thing about this, I'm still in the entryway. The other thing about this unit, it's okay, I got a big walker. Some people say it's a Cadillac or a Brougham. A bus driver told me I need to put some Armorall on the tires. Anyway, that's neither here nor there. So the walker can only fit in the kitchen, and we'll get in the kitchen in a minute. Let me see, can it go in the living room? Okay, so the walker can go into the kitchen and the living room, but it cannot, which is out of my order of what I was going to film, but anyway, it cannot go into this second bedroom because of these wheels right here. The wheels in the back are positioned wider than the wheels in the front. So this is as far as I can go with my walker. Good thing I have a cane. So I just wanted to show that because it only goes into the entryway, kitchen, and living room. I guess once I'm in the entryway, I just use my cane to get around. But that's neither here nor there. We're going to finish the walkthrough. Okay, so starting from the entryway away again. Oh, let me take the mask off so you guys can hear me. Okay, so these first set of folding doors on the left side, as you can see, they don't close properly or open at all. I think that's where the water heater is, but they're not opening. Looks nice on camera, but it's not opening. And like I say, it's dark in this entryway because the light doesn't come on. Okay, we're heading into the kitchen now. Whew! And let's see what we got in the kitchen. I'm gonna have to come back and check all the outlets and see if they work. But look at this floorboard. You see this lovely paint job? I know you see it. I know you see it. We'll zoom in later in the editing process, but I'm sure from here you can see it. That's all I'm gonna say about that. So this is the floor, you know, your standard tile. Sorry for the echo, don't have my headsets. They're in storage somewhere. So bear with me. So that's the floor. I don't know what that spot is. Oh, another paint spot, because there's paint everywhere on all the tiles throughout the whole complex. So I think of the area I am in now. Now the walls are painted good. Let me back up. So this section here, I believe is like where you can have like a little breakfast nook or maybe some more cabinetry if you need to. I think that's what needs to happen here because it's just an open space, which I don't mind because I actually like space. I wish this wall was gone. And then it'll be really an open concept because the living room was on the other side. But let me be grateful. Okay, so I'm about to turn around. We're going to see the rest of it. Yeah, well, as you know, I moved in, so I do have some stuff on the counter already. I haven't unpacked, and there's a reason why. And we'll get to that momentarily. But I just wanted you to see the cabinetry. And I do like the sink though. The sink is pretty deep. I don't know if it's gonna be big enough because I wanted one of those over the sink draining racks, but we'll see. I'll have to measure that and see if that works. So forgive the mess, like I said, but you see what I got there. I got some bleach and I got some Ajax. We about to get this started. So we're going to start with the refrigerator. Okay, so nice size refrigerator. And there's some more drawers. Oh, I didn't really pay attention to drawers. I probably only use the first drawer because I can't bend past my waist. Well, I can, but I don't know if I'll get back up. So we're going to the freezer. Which, can you see that? I know you see that. Which has not been cleaned. Look at that. That is disgusting. And I don't know if they can find me a new rack with all this rust right here. Sorry, let me pull back some. Sorry if it's jittery. I don't have a stabilizer. I'm just showing you. Okay. Now we're going into the refrigerator. I had a few food particles with me in the
in the shelter. I had approval for food, and then when they changed management, they were like, oh, you can't bring your own food in anymore. And I'm like, wait a minute, I got a doctor's note.
But it seems like they did go to a healthy menu. I don't know how some people feel about it, but oh well. But look at this. You know what that is, right? I know you know. I'm just not even going to mention it. I got some stuff for that a lady from the shelter did give me. And she says it works miracles because I have a couple respiratory issues and I'm not supposed to be around that.
Okay. I think the timer, well, I think I get 3 more minutes. I think it only lets me film 10 minutes at a time. So this oven or stove looks crazy. Let me just stay still for a minute. I don't know what that is. I think I have a friend that says she's going to come and help me clean and set up and put that gel stuff down because we're about to open some cabinets and I'm not a happy camper. No ma'am, no how. Here we go. Let's see what we have in this cabinet because it's over the stove. I think I will have it be my spice cabinet, the one on the left. My pots and pans will probably go in the middle cabinet. And then, you know, your cans and canned goods will go on the right. I believe that's how I'm going to position that. And then in turning, you know, moving to the right, that left cabinet will probably be, you know, probably the glasses and cups. And then the other cabinet will be plates. And this cabinet will possibly, which I probably don't even want to do that, but possibly, you know, your dry goods. I don't know what I'll do with these two cabinets. The three. We'll figure that out. This little open space. I'm sure that's for decorations, but I hate knickknacks. Okay. We'll be back. My timer's going down. I gotta re-upload. Hold on. All the other cabinets, I guess, I don't know. It freaked me out. Look, there's another one. Let's see what's under the sink. There's more. Look at that big old trap. That's a giant trap. My biggest fear is this. Look at that. Look at it. Forgive me for screaming. Oh my God. Okay. I don't think people understand the severity of when you say you have respiratory issues, that you're not supposed to be around roaches because they have diseases and their little nasty little flesh goes out in the particles in the air and getting to your throat and getting your bronchitis, bronchial tubes, and then you'll have a reaction and then you can't breathe. I sleep with a CPAP. Okay. That is the kitchen, and I'm so disgusted. Y'all know how I feel about this, but what can I do? Rent is paid for years, so I guess there's not much I can do about it.
So let's go on to the dining room.
Lord have mercy.
Now, of course, my camera stopped and I had to recharge my phone. So I already have some stuff on the wall, my little vision board. So don't mind that. But we're getting ready to go into the dining room. Sorry about that bright light. Doesn't look bright in here, but I guess you know I have a lot of light. A lot of light comes through in here, so that's good. That's my little vision for the dining room. We'll talk about that another time. We'll talk about this lamp another time. Now, this chandelier, or, well, you know, this light thing, tell me why I bumped my head on it. It's the same level as me, so. The paint job, you know, like I said, is shabby. Shabby paint job. Look at that. Look at that. I mean, the apartment is nice, I can say, but this was a rush thing. They just hurried up and put me somewhere because, you know, I wasn't trying to go back to the shelter, but they need to come back and assist me. While I was charging my phone and I was making phone calls. Okay, we're getting ready to go into the living room. So the living room is pretty spacious, as you can see. That over there on the wall is another vision board, and the other stuff on the wall is where I want my furniture to be placed. Yeah, I was a little busy while I was charging my phone. Anyhow, so this is the living room. That's the hallway, and as you see, my walker's still in the entryway. I think the walls are okay. So anyway, as I was saying, as I was charging my phone, I called the electric company to set up my service, and it turns out there was a slight street difference. So I called the leasing office to make sure what my correct address is. That picture looks crazy in this camera. Let me just get closer. Okay, that, the flash is not helping. Okay, so that is my vision for the living room. It's supposed to represent the deep sea. Anyhow, so as I was calling the leasing offices, I was telling them about the lovely roaches. And they were basically telling me that, what did they say? They said normally they have a contractor that comes out and cleans once they're setting up the apartments. So she told me that I would have to call the vice president and also email the maintenance person. So I emailed the maintenance person and CC'd my, while I'm talking, let me just show you this picture of the dining room, my vision for the dining room. So while I was talking, I emailed the maintenance person and then I CC'd my case manager. And my case manager says, okay, well, let me call. So she got in touch with the vice president because when I called the vice president, it went straight to the voicemail. So she got in touch with the vice president and he basically told her that I basically have to clean it myself because the contractor is not going to come out. This like a, I guess, a one-stop shop. When they are setting up the apartments, they, I guess, they have a series of apartments at one time, and then they will have the cleaning service come out. So I'm gonna need somebody to come help me clean. Cause I can't do it. I can't be around them. They don't understand. I'm gonna have to find them an article of why you are not supposed to be around roaches. Call it what it is. Okay, so we're getting ready to, we're not going into that room yet. Sorry for the lighting. We're getting ready to go into the restroom. This will be the guest room. Oh, goodness gracious. Oh, that's bright. Sorry. I'm going into the
restroom. And as you can see what it looks like through the mirror, because I'm not getting on camera. And we're going to see what these cabinets look like in a minute, because I'm scared.
If you like listening to funny, sad, ridiculous stories, please subscribe. Mom would say it's like a bad sitcom.
So, you know, it's a decent bathroom. My bathroom will be the beach. Well, this bathroom will be the beach. And since it turns out I have two bathrooms, let's see, this is floor. Well, that's dirt from shoes from yesterday. I thought it had paint on the floor. Oh, the camera's about to go out again. I will be back. Some more paint splatter on the floor. I see I'm gonna have to have someone come and help me clean this place. What is that? Sorry, y'all. There's something there. Let's see what else is going on in these cabinets. And I need to go back. Sorry. Okay, y'all, forgive me. I need to. This is a video, but it's also a. Oh Lord, please don't let my phone fall into the toilet. But I also need to see if the toilet works. So bear with me. At least this toilet doesn't look rusty. Like, I'll show y'all in a minute. Okay, the bathroom, of course, needs to be cleaned. I was hoping that the program would have provided me some cleaning supplies, because it looks like I really, really need them. We're going back into the hallway because I just noticed something. I'm going to have to turn this way. Okay, so this door to the laundry, the track is working fine. Oh, that's horrible. Okay, I'm just going to have to tell y'all because it's not going to do right. So the doors to the linen closet, the right side, the track works fine. This left side is off track. I wonder if you can see that. Let's try to close the door. See, the track is not, the little thing is not on the track like that one. And, you know, again with the paint job. Okay. So we're moving on into the first bedroom. Well, the small bedroom. Of course, everything's been vacuumed, so of course you have vacuum lines. I haven't been in this room that much compared to the other's room. You know, we still have our lovely paint job. I did notice in the dining room, which I forgot to mention, that there's cracks in the crown molding. But I guess that's normal wear and tear. And like I said, I'll go back and check these sockets off camera. I'm just making sure everything is cool. And then, you know, has just one of those regular wide closets. Oh, I didn't check these doors. Let me see if these doors work. One kind of catches. So the right door kind of catches. I thank y'all for coming along on this journey with me. So, I mean, the doors look nice from here. Of course, on camera, you can't see all the details, but this room actually is pretty nice.
And this is the second bedroom. So now we're going into the master. Now in the master, they provided me a air mattress until I get my furniture, because they are providing me with furniture. So I'm going to be grateful. There's my handy dandy. Oh, Lord, I didn't make up the bed. Okay, hold on. Okay, I picked up the pillows and things. Here's the thing. I love the fact that they gave me this mattress. However, with my back, it's not going to allow me to sleep on it. So, ergo, I was sleeping on the floor. That's why there was pillows on the floor. Not that y'all need to know about all that. Anyhow, this is the bedroom. Of course, I have some of my stuff already in here. You know, just got here yesterday. Whatever day this uploads, just know I got here yesterday. So far, so good. As I was laying down, because sometimes you can see more stuff when you lay down than when you're just walking upright. So as I was laying down, I didn't see any issues here in the bedroom portion. And it's pretty spacious. Oh, I take that back. There is an issue. Let me turn the camera the other way. This right here. How did I dare say that I didn't see any issues? So this is on the four wall across from the door. And I hope and I pray to God that's not mold. I just thought about that. Is that mold? Okay. Oh, there you go. Woo, Father. You know what your daughter needs. And you know, you got me in this vessel that has some respiratory issues, so we need a miracle, Father. We just gonna put it like that. We need a miracle so I can stop stressing out. I'm not supposed to be anxious. I'm supposed to trust in you. Yes, sometimes I have to talk to myself. You know, you got to encourage yourself. Okay, so sorry to have y'all look at a blank wall. So now we're getting ready to go into, I'm trying to do this without being on camera. Because all I have on is a muumuu. But as you can see, it has a vanity and then the mirror and then some, cabinetry. Let's see. But before you get to that part, it's like a little small hallway. And, you know, you have a walk-in closet. You can't really see, but it's a nice walk-in closet. I mean, you got one side over here, one side over there to hang up your belongings. Which I'm going to do that after I finish filming. I will be hanging up my belongings. But, you know, I needed to do the walkthrough first. Oh, and I just see the lovely paint job again. Let's just leave it right here. That is not a shadow. That's a reflection off the flashlight. But as you can see the difference, that is the lovely paint job that we've been having throughout the whole place. So, you know, I got to do this for, you know, leasing sake as well as just letting y'all take this little tour, this long tour. But anyway, so we're moving on. We are at the cabinet space. Yes, I'm hiding from the camera. I told y'all that. Anyway, let's see what we have in here. I already threw the Heineken can away. I was like, oh, so we just going to leave the Heineken can in here. It's amazing that the case managers, because they went to look at this place before they said, okay, we're going to take it. They have these cabinets open. I don't know why they didn't see that Heineken can. Now, what if I was an ex-alcoholic and then I had a relapse because they didn't pick up that Heineken can? Anyway, so here's the master bathroom section, the toilet section. But here we go again with the paint job. Of course, I'm recording this for, you know, leasing purpose. Let them know this was like this before I moved in. Okay. And let's see. And we're almost done.
I'm sure y'all are just happy to see tiles and things. Oh, look at that. Paint on the tile. Okay, this is actually helping me a lot. It's always good to record. One thing you need to know when you first move into a complex, an apartment complex, film. You know, they say a picture's worth 1,000 words. Now, one thing I can say, this bathtub compared to the other bathtub is clean. Isn't that nice? Okay, now this toilet is scaring me. On camera, you might not see it, but it looks kind of rusty. And then when you flush, it's just like, it just seems like it, I don't know. I can't explain it. In real life, it's just weird. It's weird looking and it's dingy and it's just getting on my nerves. Anyhow, that ends my tour of my new place. I'm going to learn how to be grateful. I'm sure I can get some folks to help me clean. I do need to call the program again and ask them to round me up some cleaning supplies at least, because most of the time these kind of programs, do supply cleaning needs. So I'm gonna need them to at least do that for me, seeing how I'm dealing with these roaches that I didn't want to deal with. Part of the master bedroom. I guess this was them changing the shower. This is like, what do you call it? Bathtub stopper. And it's just hanging up here. I keep bumping into it, but I was just putting it back the way it was when I got here. Okay, off to the patio because I see something I don't like. So now we're going to the patio because I didn't inspect that yet. I probably shouldn't be showing you these people's backyard. But I opened the blinds and I was getting ready to step out. And y'all know what that is. Oh, Father, be with me. Please let it be resolved quickly. I need someone to come help me clean. Woo! Yes, ma'am. Okay. Well, the sliding door somewhat works. There's a little pressure trying to get it over there. Let's see if I can step out here with no problem. You know, you got your normal dust and stuff, so, you know, I'll have to get that swept up. So far, I don't feel like I'm gonna fall off of here. Oh, this is nice. I didn't know it was indoor screen. I don't know if you can see that, but I like that. Oh. Okay, we got, I mean, there's hope here. I'm just scared about the one thing that would cause more respiratory issues. That's my biggest thing out of anything. I didn't even mind if I would be in the hood as long as there wasn't those. But, let's see what this storage unit is about. It looks so dark from the camera, but it's not that dark. So I'm just going to see what's going on in the storage unit. It's actually a pretty decent storage unit. They put some shelves. Oh, look. I don't know if you can see that, but there's some hooks. Oh, somebody was thinking. Okay. Big old bug over there. Somebody going to have to get because I ain't doing it. But other than that, why does the storage closet seem, the outside storage closet seems cleaner than the cabinets in the kitchen? I mean, I know this was a rushed move, but I wish they had it all together from the jump. Because, let's see, I signed up with the housing program in January and it's now March. So I wish they had the correct kind of apartment for me, and then I wouldn't have to deal with this. But that's neither here nor there. This latch is giving me some problems. Have to put y'all on hold. But that's my tour. I thank y'all for watching.
Like I always say, remember to toast to life because it always makes for a great story. Please remember to check out my other content on the channel. Please like, share, and subscribe. Hit the bell. And I'll see you next time. Hopefully next week I'll be back on schedule now that I have a place to be. Anyway, bye.